That is not.
But seriously speaking, I am just getting into my break.
I know, you know.
Don't they see you on air?
No, someone just wanted to tell me that I am on the menu. So I'm sorry, I'm on the menu.
Oh, people. And it is, of course, the second hour of Urban Today. Now, in studio with me, I have a gorgeous, gorgeous woman. I have told her I'm going to give her my blazers. And then Imi ruined it and told her that my brothers are broke. And I said, it's okay. I got money. I will finance my brothers.
No, I am looking out for sisters. We are committing so very many sins because the men out there are broke.
Jesus.
Now, you let me be. I work for myself. Baby girl.
In studio with us.
Not really. I can do
everything for myself.
Jesus. Like I went, okay, introducing a Nalulinje. In studio with us, we have a beautiful one. As you can see, she's as tall as me. Yes, I am tall like that. I'm wearing.
Did you see how she laughed at you? Like the actual lol of Tina, you're short.
And I have a 2019 second runner up, Miss International, EVE. How are you, darling?
Oh, I'm okay, thank you. How are you?
How is the Garden of Eden?
Amazing. Oh, sorry.
No,
I was replying amazing to your question. The Garden of Eden.
Yeah, she's called Eve.
So
yeah. Adam and Eve.
Yeah. Do you got an Adam?
I huh?
And not now, not yet. Yeah.
Mm. I don't believe her.
Sing
now.
The song. Loving you is easy because you're beautiful.
So you guys have Adams?
No, wait for the part.
No, I don't. Do you have an
da, 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 da. No, I have seven Adams. One Adam is for hair. The other Adam is for apples.
Well,
the other
I'm Adam not is friends for... with her. I just need for you to understand.
Banange tukiriziganye nti. Nadala mu December wano omuntu abayetaga ba Adam.
Yeah.
Adamu Enviri, Adamu Airtime, Adamu OTT, Adamu.
You know what? Wama Eve, don't follow this one. Mm-hmm. She will just throw you in hot
it's
pepper.
Okay.
Now, because it is the love letter, we are going to be delving into none other than love issues. Now, let's start this one by saying, what if she brings me an STD?
It is on the menu.
Girl, what's on your menu?
I just read the letter and I love that part. Like, I can't help it.
What's on your menu? Your menu is
just read the letter and then you're going to see why I'm saying menu.
Hello, Urban Today. I have an ex of mine who recently got married. Less than a year ago, we occasionally talk and she recently said she wanted to come visit me. It's
wait
a trap.
It?
I think sex is on
the menu.
Part of my thought says this is a good idea since I've not had sex in a while, but then deep I am worried since... I do not know the motive behind this. What if she is bringing me an STD?
It's on the menu.
Or even setting me up?
It's on the menu.
What should I do? Please advise. Now, can I ask this gentleman before any of you goes into it? Kwegamba for us, exes, we'll be just there.
On the menu.
No, we'll be just there
to
looking for STDs and who to give them to. We first go
so
out
like,
there.
How can it be? How can it be like?
I have a
STD.
Do you want some?
Do you want some?
Oh my God.
Which STD do you want? Herpes, gonorrhea, syphilis, girlfriend? I got them all. Like, first of all, this for me is disturbing. How is it disturbing? She's an ex.
Mm.
She recently got married, which clearly states in more ways than the other. One, her marital home is not satisfaction.
Yeah.
Sexually.
Mm-hmm.
Two, there are rare chances of you catching an STD.
Yeah.
Because she's with one person and just jumped out to look for an old person.
Mm.
If anything, you're bringing the STDs.
La, 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 la,
but
la.
That's my thought. Eve, what do you have to say about this letter?
I think he's not yet sure if she's really like meeting him for sex. He's just.
Why else would your ex be calling
it's
you?
Okay, no, Tina, let's
it depends. I think it depends on the kind of relationship that you had before. Probably you were friends, and I'm actually going
maybe
through
just sex buddies.
Exactly.
Now.
No, I didn't say.
She got me.
I didn't say that. So I'm trying to say probably you were best friends during your relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You know, aside the loving ish. And probably she's going through...
My ex was my best friend. I don't think I'm going to call him up for some anytime
soon.
It's
okay. This is Tina. Just get used to Tina. Keep going.
Okay, like I'm trying to say, probably she's going through some hard time and she needs someone to talk to.
Mm.
You know, so I'd advise that guy to tell her let's meet openly, you know, and see what she's really up
you
to.
You do know that even if we're meeting can end up at your place
or my place.
Exactly, but you need to first find out that. Oh. That's really what I'm looking for.
But seriously speaking,
it's okay, it's okay.
No, no, let me ask you. If you reached out to your ex, not he reached out, if you reached out to your ex, isn't that a trap? Don't you know why you're going back?
Sex is on the menu. Let's go back to that. Okay, this is the thing.
Someone is going down regardless.
This is the thing. Like, it is okay. In December, are we allowed to call people stupid or naive or dense?
They told me to stop using the word stupid.
Okay,
you can use mentally challenged.
Mentally challenged. Okay, dear boy, here is Pac Mother talking to you. Mm. Wake the hell up.
Mm-hmm.
She is your side. What? She's your ex. Like, how do you manage to take 20 steps forward and then you go like, hooray, on the menu, I'm taking 100 steps back? Who does that?
What menu ngeberako spaghetti bolognese? Eriko simanya straganofu, eriko simanya gundi,
eriko ne gurunedi. And on that note,
first wait.
No.
Not only the menu, no gamba bati. Today's chef special. So you have to.
This is where I need someone like Aine here. He would be saying, Yeah, cookie. Someone would be. He has a certain level of excitement.
Would you call your ex?
Not really. I don't think I would.
Like, if
you
were just.
No.
Let me make you to your words. You said, like, if you're a friend.
It depends on the kind of relationship that you had before.
Like,
I still go back to that.
Like, the one of talking, shoulder to cry.
We used to talk, you know. About
my
child,
whenever someone just does that whole shoulder to cry, you know, and
it's okay.
Someone is going down.
Yeah. It cannot be on the menu.
Down.
Okay.
You will be on someone's menu whether you want it or not. But anyway, this guy's biggest problem is one.
He has not had sex in a while.
Yes.
And she could bring an STD.
Mm-hmm.
I, on the other hand, I'm saying, liko boy, liko youth, Abi stand up. If you want to be on someone's menu, Abi be on it. Do not begin saying, Mbushi will come with an STD. If anything, you're the guy with an STD.
Exactly.
She is married in her home. If she's reaching out to you, guess what? I'm sorry. It's a trap. She wants some. Now, strap up or take your time and go have it tested.
Mm-hmm.
But I just want you to know you are on a menu.
Someone is on the menu.
Menu.
Katitina, what is on the menu today? What is on the menu?
Menu.
Mm. Break down the menu.
Now, on the menu today,
on the menu
for
today,
this guy, one is an ex,
mm-hmm,
which means it is guaranteed sexual situation, because
There
is no way
keep
you
going
can tell me, I don't know how my ex's situation is sexual. No. You know what his ex situation is. So
yeah.
On the menu, we have STDs.
Okay, STDs, okay.
We have cookies.
Okay.
Cucumbers.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Stay sane. Mm-hmm.
And
keep
then
going on the menu.
We have traps too.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That is the menu right now.
Okay, and on the menu still?
On the menu still, there are chances of, you know, I will not like you.
Now, guys, okay.
You know, let them call us out. Call us out in case you want to have a conversation with us. The studio lines are always open. Call us and let us know. Na mulia nafna STD.
Oba tamulia nafna STD.
We need to first ascertain, are you menu or not? Do you think are you menu or not?
I think so.
He's on the menu. What's the only other reason you'd call your ex for?
To just talk and remind us.
Like,
what
I would call my
ex. Other reason to call your ex?
Like, if this guy over here that I married is not good enough in some areas, then I go like, time to backslide a little. Imi, call up your ex. He was good in.
Oh my
goodness.
God.
Then, like, I just need. Meanwhile,
do you know why I'm asking her?
Where?
Because, one, you are part of the whole Miss World thing that is happening now.
Yes, yeah.
So, you know your menu is going to be bigger. You have a bigger menu.
A menu?
Menu.
The menu.
Yeah.
And you have your own menu and then you're also on someone else's menu. How is the Miss World thing going, by the way?
How is the menu in Miss?
I was at Miss International, but Miss World is now going on right
okay,
now
the Miss International bit.
Yeah.
Do you have a Mr. International?
Yes, actually, they're there.
Do you get to date him?
No.
I'm sorry, it came out. Did I say it out loud?
You have a twisted one muscle in those menus and circles.
Yeah.
What? Tina is doing the tapping.
No.
Let's do this. Let's do this dinner. So, in your world of Miss
Obama, yeah.
No, but seriously, let's talk about this.
Do you
think it is right for him to actually do go to her? And what if sex is on the menu? What should he do?
If he doesn't want, then he says no.
And if he wants,
then he does it. I mean, he wants.
The old broom. That's what he
says.
Yeah, exactly.
So, are you team? Should he be put on the menu? Or Tim, she is a married woman, the guy might find you, but kube binyo, babi gem.
Yes, I'm that
ofune, STD.
I'm that team.
STD.
So you should know.
You're a married woman.
Okay.
The guy might find you. So you shouldn't. And actually, you might even get STDs from the guy.
She did say STDs. Yes. Okay. Let me try and be sent
first
here.
First, someone is going to say, Eve Tetunamu Tegere, Eve. Can you please give us your full titles now? Because we need to make people understand why we have Kulemerad on the menu.
Okay.
Full title.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm Evelyn Namato of Chironde, and I'm Miss International second runner-up. And I was the best in swimsuit as well.
Yeah, I'm there. Keep going.
Swimsuit.
Yes.
She's looking at her fingers.
Yes, the swimsuit.
Yeah. And I was the only African in among the top five.
Oh, how did that feel?
Very good.
So how come you didn't try out for Miss Uganda though?
I did in 2016 and I was among the top five, and again I was Miss Beach Beauty.
Wow.
Yeah, so.
But we need to see this body that just keeps winning.
Like, Beach Beauty, can't you just Beach stand
didn't
up?
Didn't you see it?
No!
She did. She.
Oh,
wow.
Okay.
Look at
that. Okay. These are the people supposed to be women. This is a menu.
Tina go movie yo. Whoa.
Whoa. So how has it been though? Well, let's first leave this one and his STDs. How's it been though being a beauty pageant?
Yeah, it gives you a lot of experiences. You meet a lot of people. Like, you know, we were 83 countries there. So it means you're meeting different 83 girls. Not boys.
Only girls.
Only girls.
So wait, do beauty pageants never meet up with the beauty? What are
male pageants? Sikurimba. Why you get a bucket list?
Huh?
Kachichiri nange ku bucket list. Nange mbwambale.
Okay.
Mbele
anyway.
Ku menu.
Okay, nze ni ku menu.
On the menu today is Pac Mada. With no STDs.
Yeah, of course you don't have any.
Anyway, for all of you who want to partake in this letter, I will read it one last time. Hello, Abin, today I have an ex of mine who recently got married. Less than a year ago, we occasionally talk. She recently said she wanted to come visit me. I think sex is
on the menu.
Part of my thought says this is a good idea since I have not had sex in a while. But then deep, I am worried. Since I don't know the motive behind this, what if she's bringing me an STD or even setting me up? What should I do?
What if I got it? What if she's just bringing a baby and she wants to give you that baby?
Hmm?
Like when you go down and like the other side, I got stuck at the baby.
At the baby?
baby is also on the menu.
Really?
You know,
yeah.
The phone lines are open out there. You can check on your TV screen. Call us and let us know. I personally think this guy is lying to himself. And
this letter is a joke, so I would love to just
put it. It's not a joke.
No.
It's not a joke. He's actually
like,
considering being put on
how
a sexual
How stupid
exactly.
can a man not say no to an ex?
Thank
How
you.
Stupid can a man be known to say no to a married ex? Like, how naive can you be?
Do you know if her situation was good when you were with her, you can't say
no. Whether the situation was good or not, it's in the past.
Because look at this. This is a guy who is deliberately telling you, I haven't been laid in a very
long time.
Anyway, let's pick these calls. Abin today, hello. Hello. Good morning. Hello, Abin today, hello. Please step away from your TV sets when you do call us. The feedback is too crazy. Just stay away from your television set and then call us in and let us know what should he do. He thinks it's a strap. She could be bringing an STD or it could be a setup, but she's been married for one long year.
Yeah.
And even in that long year, they have been talking, which clearly says, I have a feeling these guys have
actually
been cheating on each other.
No,
we need to accept some of these things
in life.
Let's
get this call. Abin today, hello.
You know, we need to accept some few things in life. When you break up with someone,
you have broken up.
Maybe you're not both committed. But this is, you've broken up.
Exactly.
And she has moved on.
Yeah,
and she's married.
Yeah.
But now she's calling you back. Number one, the woman is partly to blame.
She's okay, maybe.
But, you know, it's like a bit like how you've just broken up and then you delete the guy's number, then somehow the number is in your head,
then you pick up your phone,
then you're calling, then you're pretending to hang up,
then
you're hurting yourself. You understand? Eh?
Yeah.
Like when she goes ahead, one of you needs to be the sane one. In this
let's
the man
this
who is
caller.
Sexually deprived should be the one to say no.
Abin today, hello. Good morning, Abin today.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What's your name and where are you calling us from, love? Hello. Hello.
Please reduce the volume on your telly.
You actually need to step away from your television set when you call us because the feedback. Alright, let's pick up this one. Abin today, hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
What's on the menu?
Airtime, you have to mungeza. Two charges, one for me. Well, scratch cards. Abin today, hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Morning.
What's your name and where are you calling us from, love?
Hello, morning.
Morning.
Yeah, for me, what I said.
Yes.
I said that girl should leave because.
Should leave.
Yeah, should not even bother.
It's a trap.
Yeah, it's a trap. Should not bother.
Why?
Cause. First of all, he thought that he's going to him the what? So maybe God is on his side.
Maybe she's telling him that there's a scholarship for him to study.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, let's pick up this one too. Abin today, hello. Hello. Abin today. I think we lost that one, but I have a question. Why does he have to fear an STD? Does it mean he was going to have unprotected sex with someone he broke up with?
A year ago.
I'm not sure I want to say the response on.
No, you can't say it. Anyway, give us a phone call. Let us know. Or better yet, you can hit us up on our different social media platforms. Hello. Abin today, hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Nambi Kendez Ateli. Kendez.
Hello.
Hello, good morning. What's your name and where are you calling from?
This is Fiona.
Yes, Fiona. What advice do you have for this guy?
Hello, good morning. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Please stay away from the TV set. I know magalo kwe wulidanga muri kumpe wanae. Communication eringa blacka one.
Omanye.
Hello.
Hello.
Pick up this one. Abin today. Hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Morning.
What's your name and where are you calling us from, love?
Oh my God.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes. Good morning. What's your name and where are you calling us from?
No.
Someone just said that men are actually scared
are
to
scared.
Talk because they're seeing a gorgeous girl on the set.
What does it say for the two of us?
Hello. Abin today, hello.
No.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, good morning.
Morning to you.
What's your name and where are you calling us from?
This is Ken Love from Within.
Oh yes, Ken Love from Within. What advice do you have for this brother?
Okay, first of all, we all need to understand that as in relationship, we have two different relationships.
True.
We have love relationship and friendship relationship. Mm. So when the love, the other part fails, you don't break the friendship.
Oh, really?
So it's normal for that girl to say, I want to pay a visit because, as my sister stated, she could be bringing him a good news. Let's not only look at that sex in the menu you're talking about.
Yeah.
Leave that one out.
But it's the guy who is hoping that there is sex.
Yeah, I'm advising him that let him stop seeing that because for him, if he has finally decided, he's the one
who
has the power to everything. There's no way you can say you can come visit me and you force me into you. No.
Okay,
so let him be a man and wait for the message and wait for what is in the menu. But sex, no. Let him respect the lady.
Okay, Ken. I feel you. So, you, my guest is actually very excited with your analysis.
Yes, because I said that at the beginning. You never know what kind of relationship they're having.
Like,
and besides, she's not going to force the guy to have anything.
Have you bumped into one ex of yours and just gone like...
Nze tina ensi yaba ex njitia ba ex bali ne mize ba ex ngendo bazuku sangene wali ye kizibu so I am basing it on me eranze sembe za ba ex bonana na ba blocking manya na ba jokwa no ji blocking buri ex na mu blocking na ye I have a paper where are their numbers just
then you did block them. You can't them at a
no, guys, meet me halfway. Like right now.
The numbers in the paper.
Yeah. That's the point. On a paper, could be rained on. It could be eaten by the rats.
Lord.
Like anything could happen to the paper.
But I also have a friend.
Yeah.
She has an ex. They were friends before going into a relationship. So when they broke up.
They stayed friends.
Exactly. Best friends, actually.
Are you
and the
sure
guy was actually fine with it.
I was
are you sure? They don't got a little.
They don't eat their cookies?
No, they do not.
Cooking on the menu.
I'm very sure. You know why? Because she truly loves this other guy that she has, and this guy is also fine with it.
Don't confuse sex and
no,
love.
We need this girl to stay with us so she can bring back the innocence to our minds. Like you and
perverted.
I, we are perverted, Tina.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, no, not me. Not me.
Both of you.
Both of us.
No.
Anyway, this conversation could definitely go on for a whole long while. Thank you for being with us. This is, of course, EVE. I'm not calling her Eve. That just sounds wrong. EVE 2019, second runner-up Miss International. She's gorgeous. She's gorgeous.
What does she define beauty? Define beauty.
Beauty is a lot of things. I believe beauty shouldn't be about your physical appearance. It should also come from within. Like, you should be beautiful inside and out.
Okay, for all my men out there who are seeing inner beauty, Bambi, Mbatumi,
are they moving with scanners?
X-ray scanners. For all of you who see inner beauty, this one is for you. She said inner beauty is the thing. Anyway, let's take a short break, and when we do come back, we're going to be delving into the world of sports with Nicholas Rububi, myself, which is going to be disastrous, but I'll be here. Let's take a short break.